Hey, what's up everybody? So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make a 5% fruit acid facial serum. I did a 5% fruit acid facial toner not too long ago, so I'll link that video down below, but now it's time to make it into a serum. So here's the formulation I have typed out into percents for you guys. So you can just easily screenshot this recipe and go back to it whenever you want to make this recipe. So you can just easily transfer these percents to a weighed out recipe. And if you don't know how to do that, I will link that video down below in my description box so you guys can figure out exactly how to do that. So today we're going to be making a 1/2 ounce bottle of this fruit acid facial serum. So let's get started. So first grab a digital scale that weighs to 0.01 grams and some kind of beaker. I'm using this 50 milliliter glass beaker to make my facial serum in. So I went ahead and added in 9.9 grams of distilled water. You can use like aloe vera liquid or some kind of hydrosol here if you would like instead. Next, I'm using this ingredient I've never used on my channel before, but it's called propandiol. And it's a lot like vegetable glycerin. So if you have vegetable glycerin, you can easily substitute this ingredient out for glycerin. But this ingredient is a great moisturizing ingredient, and I went ahead and added in 0.6 grams of it. If you would like to learn more about propandiol, I'll put a link down in my description box for you guys so you can learn a lot more about it. Next, I'm going to be adding in some green apple fruit essence. This stuff smells absolutely amazing, but it also has some great moisturizing properties to the skin, but I'm mainly just using it for the fragrance. And I added in 3 grams of the apple fruit essence. It gives the serum a nice fruity scent that goes well with the fruit mix. Next, we are adding the fruit mix. So this is a combination of sugars and like orange extract and lemon extract to create a natural alpha hydroxy acid. So this is great for exfoliating dead skin cells off of the skin and just creating a nice smooth surface on the skin. If you want to learn more about alpha hydroxy acids, I'll put a link down below to my video where I talk all about alpha hydroxy acids and the benefits they have for the skin. So I added in 0.75 grams of the fruit mix. Next up is our preservative, which I'm using Lewicidal SF Complete, and this is a water-soluble broad-spectrum preservative. You can substitute it out for any other water-soluble broad-spectrum preservative you want to use. And I used 0.6 grams of the Lewicidal SF Complete. Then I just mixed everything together to make sure it was all well combined before I add in my hyaluronic acid. And I added in 0.15 grams of the hyaluronic acid. And this works as a gelling ingredient, and it is great for helping eliminate fine lines and wrinkles. If you want to learn more about hyaluronic acid, I've talked about it in a lot of my past videos, but I'll put a link down below to where you can purchase it, and they have all kinds of information about it if you want to learn more. So if you haven't seen my past serum videos, well, you wouldn't know that hyaluronic acid is really hard to break up in the water. It honestly just doesn't break up. It just kind of sits on the surface of the water. So do your best to try to break up the hyaluronic acid in the water as much as possible, but I promise you it probably won't. So I just mix it up as much as I possibly can, break it up as much as I can, and then I cover my beaker with like plastic or aluminum foil, and I let it sit for 3 hours. And when you come back, it'll be this nice, clear, translucent gel texture, and it just feels absolutely amazing on the skin. So now that it is all finished, it is time to package up our serum, and I'm using this 1/2 ounce glass dropper bottle to store my serum in. I'll put a link down below to where I purchased these bottles, and I'll also try to find some similar ones over on Amazon. So then the last thing I did is I made a little custom label to go on my fruit serum. And if you don't know how to make custom labels, I'll link down below to a video where I show you guys exactly how I make mine and how I waterproof them. So if you're not sure how to use a alpha hydroxy acid serum, well, you want to use it after you cleanse and tone the skin, and you want to put it on your skin while it's still damp. Also, you only need about 2 or 3 drops, and when you're using alpha hydroxy acids, you want to make sure you're protecting your skin from the sun. So make sure you're wearing a sunscreen for up to 7 days after use, because alpha hydroxy acids can make your skin very sensitive to the sun. So make sure you keep that in mind when using alpha hydroxy acids. So just to give you guys a little sneak peek, I will be making a 5% lactic acid facial serum next, so look forward to that video. So now that we have reached the end of this video, it is time for my Patreon shoutouts. So first up, we have Herbalist Tracy, who owns Essence of Nature over on Etsy. I did a review over her shop in the past, so I'll link that video down below, along with a direct link to her Etsy shop. Next up is Musical Mood Ring, who owns Stardust Bath & Body. As of right now, her website is not live, but you can go over there, type in your email, and get notified when it goes live. You can also go follow her over on Instagram at Stardust Bath & Body. Next up is Nature's Farm Girl, and she sells all kinds of natural skincare and body care products, so go check out her shop. Next is Kennedy's Essentials, and they sell all kinds of natural hair care products, and I did a review over her products before. I'll link that video review down below as well. Next is Let's Blend, and guess what? I did a review over her products as well. So I'll have that video review linked down below, along with a direct link to their shop. Next is actually a spa that is located in Miami, Florida, and they offer plant-based facials and all kinds of other amazing things, and it is called Young Forever Aesthetics. You can also go follow them over on Instagram at Young Forever Aesthetics and see what they offer over there. Check them out. Last but not least is Rise Porter, who owns Creative with Love, and her shop literally looks like Valentine's Day. It is so cute, so go check her out. If you didn't know, I do sell skincare products myself over on Etsy. I'll put my link down in the description box and up in the corner for you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed this recipe, and I hope you guys have a great week. Bye! I'm stuck in the motions. I've been consumed by the wrath of time like I'm from. I'm shattered in this life. It's still the path that I've chosen. Because I've had a vision, now I'm on a mission to find myself.